the first I ever heard of Dingus Day. The end.
Dingus Day, which I learned, is mostly a Polish-American holiday.
Dingus Day to me is a lot of nonsense going on down here. We've got the pussy willows, the water. It's great when I see them luring the kids in.
Well, I know that red is very popular on Dingus Day. I know that it seems to only be celebrated in Buffalo, for what I know, and probably Poland, right? Sure.
Truck.
I think Dingus Day is an assault on pussy willows, and it's a day when a lot of people you don't normally see outside come outside, and it's awesome.
Dingus Day in Buffalo!
Yeah!
My name is Eddie Dobashevitz. I am one of the founders of Dingus Day Buffalo and Dingus Day USA. Dingus Day is really an obscure kind of an observance. So obscure that it's not even really observed in Poland to any major degree. It became, in Buffalo, a phenomenon back in the 60s. In 1961, there was a private club called the Chopin Singing Society. At the time, Ann and Ted Michael were in charge. Ted Michael was the president of the club at the time. The Chopin Singing Society had just come back from a tour of Poland and thought that Dingus Day would be a good excuse for a fundraising party. That's really how it came about. It was just an excuse for a party theme. That took on a life of its own. And it's a time of the year when days are getting longer, the weather's starting to get a little bit better, people have been cooped up for, you know, however many months because of the winter, so they're looking to kind of get out. In addition, you have these quirky little rituals that are associated with this Dingus Day observance, particularly the flirtatious chasing of men and women, young men and women, chasing each other around, splashing each other with water, and tapping each other with pussy willow branches. What is the significance of the water and the pussy willow? Well, it depends who you're talking to. It really has lots of different stories associated with it, but it all kind of probably dates back to pagan rituals which observe or commemorate the renewal of the growing season. Dingus Day was something that was unusual and unique and could not only shine a light on this neighborhood, but could help to spread the interest in Polish-American culture with younger people in particular. Dingus Day was something that had been around since 1961. However, it waned once the Chopin Singing Society left this neighborhood. The neighborhood went through that massive demographic shift. Everything kind of scattered, including whatever Dingus Day celebrations there were. We decided that a parade would be a great thing that wouldn't cost a lot of money, other than our time and effort, to gather people together, march through the streets of the historic Polonia District, put the historic Polonia District in a better light than what had been portrayed for the last 10 or 15 years in the media as one of being a war-torn, strife-ridden, poverty-stricken battle area into one of historical significance and one with potential. So the parade was a huge success right from the first year. You know, the first year we had a couple of pickup trucks and, you know, a broken down accordion and a few people walking down the streets. But there were people there in support of it, and over the next couple of years, based on our reaching out, particularly to a younger demographic in the way that we marketed the whole thing, we used things that appeal to a younger demographic. We started seeing the results of that almost immediately when we started promoting Dingus Day as a unique ethnic cultural festival.
And we're one of the polka bands in Buffalo, three-time Grammy-nominated band, Buffalo Touch. Tomorrow, of course, is Dingus Day throughout Western New York. Several places are going to have.
There's not a band to be had. If you want to have a polka band on Dingus Day, you're out of luck. Everybody from out of town comes to town. It's one day a year that more music around town and more musicians are working. And that's why you got to bless instruments, because it's a long day tomorrow. Some bands are playing 2 to 3 shows a day. It's a big party town. The whole night down east side of Buffalo gets so busy you can't move.
My name's Jay Skiba, trumpet player, vocalist with the Bedrock Boys, formerly the Ampletons. Polka music is from Europe. It was brought over almost 100 years ago with all the immigrants, and it's evolved into the modern form that it is today. It's a combination of the traditional polka from Europe, jazz, country, modern type of styles, and it's a very ethnic music that's popular not outside of Polish people, but all nationalities.
Szalała, szalała rybeczka żawową, ale ja nie będę dziewczyną za tobą. Widzisz tam dziewczyno, ty kamie na wodą, jak tam i przepłynie.
It's lost its popularity for a while, but now it's on the comeback with the younger people getting involved in it. It's a traditional music for all the Polish holidays, and that being Dingus Day, everybody comes out on Dingus Day. Everybody's Polish, like there's a song titled Everybody's Polish on Dingus Day, and that's exactly what it is. Where you have St. Patrick's Day, everybody just celebrates, everybody's Irish. On Dingus Day, everybody's Polish.
Well, you'll see a sea of red and white. You'll see young people, old people, between people, wearing red and white, smiling, waving pussy willow branches, being happy to be Polish. Younger people were looking for something. They were looking for a way to connect with their heritage. Polish Americans of all ages were in the closet about their heritage. They were embarrassed about being Polish. They loved the traditions, loved the culture associated with it. But out in the real world, they changed their names. They downplayed their Polishness. So this was a way for people to celebrate it and be happy about it. And as they should, you know, Poles have contributed vastly to the human existence. Never underestimate the power of the pussy willow.